Hi everybody, it's Dr. Renee and I'm back for part 3 of my contraception series. And this week we're going to talk about the progestogen-only methods of contraception. And there are 3 of those. They all comprise a synthetic progesterone called progestogen in various different forms, and they can be delivered in various ways, which we're going to cover. I'm going to start with the mini pill, the progesterone-only pill. And that's the one that most people probably know, and they know it as the mini pill. It contains, as I said, only progestogen, which is that synthetic hormone, and it thickens the cervical mucus to try and stop sperm from entering the womb and preventing pregnancy that way. But it also can stop ovulation, and the progestogen most likely to do that is desogestrel. And you can discuss with your provider which particular pill works for you and which particular type of progestogen you have. So it needs to be taken every day, and the most important thing about that is with most of the progestogen-only pills, it needs to be taken within a 3-hour window every day. So if you normally take your pill at 9 a.m, you need to make sure that every day you take it either 3 hours either side of this, so between 6 and midday. Any longer than that, then you won't be protected against pregnancy, apart from if your pill has desogestrel in it, and then you have a 12-hour window. So it's important that you know when you're prescribed which one you actually have and which window is important for you. If you start taking it on day 1 to 5 of your cycle, you'll be protected immediately. If you start taking it any day after day 5 of your cycle, remember the first day of your period is day 1, then you won't be protected immediately, but you will be protected after 48 hours. So you'll need extra protection in that first 48 hours to make sure you don't get pregnant. You can actually start taking it 21 days after you've given birth, so it's often the one that we use for new mums, and new mums can get pregnant, trust me. They might not be having sex or think they'll have sex, but they do get pregnant. If you miss pills, for most of the mini pills, you need extra protection for 2 days. If you're on desogestrel, you'll need extra protection for 5 days. So what are the myths, risks and side effects of the progestogen-only pill? So you may get irregular bleeding, so that means bleeding can happen at any time in your cycle, although to be fair, some women never bleed, or the bleed is much lighter. You can use it regardless of your age and if you're a smoker, so if you can't have the combined pill for that reason, this is a good option. It might be affected if you have diarrhea and vomiting, so it's always worthwhile remembering that. And some medicines may interfere with it, but your provider will go over those with you. There might be, and I say might because the evidence isn't clear, a very small increased risk of breast cancer. But if there is, it's absolutely tiny. It is, as I said, useful if you can't use other methods because you don't have so many restrictions. So in terms of side effects, some women can get acne, breast tenderness or enlargement, headaches or migraines, mood changes, changes in your libido, so your sex drive can change, nausea and vomiting, and ovarian cysts tend to be more common in women that are on the progestogen-only pill. Most of those side effects will settle. So what other methods are there, other than the pill, to deliver progestogen-only contraception? Well, the next method to discuss is the contraceptive implant, Implanon. That's one of the brands. So it's a tiny little rod, about 2 centimetres long and about 1/4 centimetre wide, that is actually inserted under the skin of the upper arm, so you can't see it. You might just be able to feel it through the skin. We use local anaesthetic to numb the area, and then a special little machine to pop it under the skin. It's quite a simple procedure. The whole thing will take about 20 minutes from start to finish. And then you don't have to think about it, it's just there doing its job and protecting you. And it does that by preventing ovulation and by thickening up the cervical mucus. Some medications can interfere with it, so you need to be aware of those when you have it fitted. If you have it fitted on day 1 to 5 of your cycle, you're protected immediately. If you have it fitted after day 5, you're protected after 7 days, so you will need extra contraception for that period. And of course it doesn't protect, nor does the pill, against sexually transmitted infections, so only the barrier methods will do that. It is more than 99% effective, so it is a very reliable method of contraception. So what are the myths, risks and side effects? Well, as I said, you don't have to think about it, so that's a major benefit. There's no remembering days, swapping, changing or taking tablets. You can get irregular periods, and some women get no periods at all. Both are absolutely safe. There's not a downside to that in terms of safety, but it's just about inconvenience if it happens to you that you bleed more. Can be taken out at any point, so if you decide that you don't want it, it's another tiny procedure under local anaesthetic to take it out. You get an instant return to fertility, as you do with all of the methods we've discussed so far, but I'm telling you that for a reason for when we discuss the next method. The minor side effects are headaches, nausea, breast tenderness, mood swings, but again they tend to settle. Acne can worsen or start even if you've never had acne before. All of these things usually settle after a few months. So that's the implant. So that's the second different way of delivering progestogen. What's the third? Well, it's an injection, so it's called the Depo method. And there are three types of injection that you can have. So there's Depo-Provera, and you have that every 12 weeks. There's Sayana, and that you have every 13 weeks. And there's Norasterat, which you have every 8 weeks. So the ones we see most commonly are Depo-Provera and Norasterat. Again, progestogen only. They thicken the mucus, they thin the womb lining so that it doesn't make it receptive for an egg, and they prevent ovulation. So they're hitting it in every which way. If you have it on day 1 to 5 of your cycle, again, as with the others, you're protected immediately. If you have it on day 5, you're not protected. Day 5 or after, you're not protected for 7 days, so you'll need extra contraception in that time. And again, it is more than 99% effective. So what are the myths, risks and side effects of the Depo? Well, you don't have to take a pill or remember it at all. Just you have to remember to go and have your injection every 8 or 12 weeks. It can reduce heavy periods and it can help with premenstrual syndrome. You get some protection, we think, against pelvic inflammatory disease, which is interesting, and also against endometrial cancer or cancer of the womb. It's not affected by medication at all, so that's good. You can have some weight gain. So we do know that this is the one method of contraception where there might be some weight gain. So about 5 kilos over 2 years has been reported. You can get headaches, acne, loss of libido, mood changes, and breast tenderness. Again, they tend to settle. It can cause a reduction in your bone density, so that's how thick and heavy your bones are, and that's important. And so the people particularly at risk are younger women, so under the age of 18, who are still developing their bones. So that's important to consider. And the other thing, and this is why I mentioned it before, is when you stop having the injection, it can actually take up to a year for your fertility to return. So if you think you might be wanting to start a family soon, this is probably not the method for you. So again, how do you decide between the different methods? Well, again, how important is it to not get pregnant? And all of these are above 99%, so again, equal. Will you remember every day to take a pill? Because if not, maybe the implant or the injection is for you. How important are regular periods? Because with all of the progestogen only, periods can be disrupted. And some women like to have a period every month. Some women love it that they won't have one. So that's important. Do you have any medical conditions? Because some of them might come into play. Do you smoke? Are you overweight? And again, I'll point you to the My Contraception tool at the Family Planning Association. I'll put a link in afterwards. And you can go into there and work out which one is best for you. So that's it for this week. And next week, we're going to cover the coils. The methods that are actually put inside us, inside our womb. So if you've got any questions prior to that or on this video today, please drop me a line, any suggestions for the future. And again, as always, thank you so much for watching. And I'm sorry my voice is a bit croaky today. I've got a dreaded cold again. The joys of being a GP. Take care.